What would you do if you need to create some buildings for your game, and you don't know any of those fancy modeling techniques like hard surface modeling, booleans, sculpting, subdivision surfaces? I say, you don't need to know all that stuff. Hello everyone, my name is Alex, and today I'm gonna show you how to create game buildings real quick and easy, with no modeling skills whatsoever. So we start from plane, and I resize it to be exactly 1 unit wide. This will be our ground piece. Now I go to shader editor and load texture I prepared before. I'll take plane UVs and scale them down to cover this piece of stone tile. It looks blurred right now. I need to go back to the shader editor and change texture filter mode to closest. Now let's configure sunlight. I'll rotate it 45 degrees to point at our ground plane and reduce intensity to about 2. I need to flip UVs so we have bright edge on the texture pointing towards some position like that. Now I can take this plane and start duplicating it to create more tiles. I take this plane and put it sideways perpendicular to the ground. This will be our building wall. I'll move UVs region down here so we have this trim panel at the ground level. Now pay attention how I'm putting this bright bevel edge at the corner where two perpendicular walls join. Let's continue duplicating plane walls and moving them around. Here I'll use darker tone of the bricks texture. I don't have texture piece with clear trim panel and without any bevel lines at both sides. To remove that bevel line, I can split this plane in two and move bricks UVs slightly to the right like that. Okay, here's a nice place for a door. I have only one door texture, so to make a double doorway, I need to flip these UVs horizontally. Now I just select all these and copy them over to the opposite side. We'll also use this technique a lot. Here I'll put a footpath and the manhole in front of the drain. Add a bit of grass for one hut. Now I'm just copying these planes over and making a side wall. This is the only method we'll use for modeling, just duplicating planes and moving them around. Same situation like before, I had to split the face in two and fix UVs manually. Now I can duplicate and move these planes up to continue building the wall. I'll put our first window here and on the opposite side. This will be our first floor. I'll try to reuse this texture piece with a trim to make a decoration over building entrance. Okay, here I think we need to add one more tile, and I'll leave some place for double windows on both sides. I move these UVs to make sure we have bevel lines around window tiles. Here I'll put these double windows. And I use these trim panels to place under them. These windows look way too flat here, I'll switch them to a bigger ones. Now to make this sidewall more interesting, I'll put a steel panel in between these windows. Here I need to fix some bevel lines. Now I can select whole sidewall and move its copy to the opposite side. We also need to flip normals so they are pointing outside. Let's do the same for the front-facing wall. I select whole block and move a copy to the other side. This time I need to rotate it 180 degrees to match build lines on the corners. These ground tiles should be flipped to face some position with the bright bevel edge. I also flipped this sidewalk texture. I can't flip this drain because I don't have its flip version on the texture, so I'll just remove it. Now I copy these ground tiles and move it to the right. Here I'll remove these drains as well. Okay, ground floor looks nice. We need to remove these tiles and put trim panels here as well. They will go under windows of the higher floors. I duplicate these two rows and move them up. Now I can add an array modifier to easily create more floors. I don't really like how shiny it looks right now. Let's go to the shader editor and reduce specular power. Here we have some free space to put even more windows. Now this is a good spot for those double windows I tried to put on the sidewall. I place some metal plates here as well. Now I can delete this rear block of panels to bring them over from the front side we just edited. Here we're missing trim panels. Let's fix that. Good thing about ray modifier is that I don't need to edit all these floors, just one piece from which copy is made. Okay, it's time to set up our camera. I'll put it to the same position where our sun object is. And let's also rotate camera the same way we rotated sun before. 45 degrees by X axis and 45 degrees by Z. I think we can use steeper angle, about 60 degrees. I'll reduce number of floors so whole building fits in the viewport. Now we can build the roof floor. I'll duplicate one of the floors and move it above the building. I don't need these trim panels here. Now I'll select all these top faces, move it up by one unit and translate UV so we have trim panels all around the top edge of the building. I'll copy this current panel to fill up the space over windows. Now I can select all of them, copy and rotate 90 degrees to hide this hole between panels. This concrete tile will fit here perfectly. Actually, I've changed my mind. Let's make all these panels concrete. Let's use triple panels all around the edge and put two drain holes in between. Now I make a copy to move it to the opposite side and rotate it 180 degrees. I'll do the same for the left side and just flip UVs so it fits the direction of the bevel lines. Okay, finally it's time to work on some roof tiling. I copy this one and rotate it 90 degrees. I have here these roof texture pieces. I need to align UVs properly so they match the direction of light. Now by copying this tile I can continue filling up the first row. And now I can select whole row of tiles and duplicate it. Just like that. I put corner tiles here and there. Very easy to do. Okay, roof is done. Now I want to make its texture more interesting. I'll select four planes here and here and put the UVs over this ventilation tile. Good. Now I'll select all building pieces and merge them together. Next step is to make some of the windows emit light like someone's there. To do that, I'll select this window and add an emission texture. Let me show you how it looks like. Where we have windows, emission texture has these yellow rectangles like light is shining through the glass. Now let's go back to the shader editor and link it up with the emission socket. Looks nice. I think it's a good time to enable some post-processing effects to spice it up. I want to enable ambient occlusion and bloom. We can make it even brighter by using additive color mix node to blend it over itself. Now I just randomly select some of the windows and assign that new shader we just made. Okay, now if we go back to our building texture, we have two banner panels here. Let's first create open banner. To do that, I'll select these two tiles over the entrance and just copy them over. I need to leave on the glow shader. Now I go to the UV editor to map the plane over the first half of the banner. Nice. I'll move it just a tiny bit in front of the brick wall and slightly above these trim panels. Now I just copy the plane and map it over the second half. But it looks all gloomy, we need to make it shine just like a neon banner. I'll go back to the shader editor to add an emission shader and let's get rid of all the nodes we had before. And now I can increase emission strength value to have a better control of its brightness. 20 looks nice. And the banner is done. Let's copy the banner we just created and move it over side wall. I'll map this plane over the first letter of the vertical banner. Now I'll do the same for the rest of the letters we have there. Looks nice. Now let's create an entrance on the top of the roof. Just a tiny box with small grey door. Here I will create a window. We also need to fix bevel lines all around the window box. Let's reuse the same roof tiles for that entrance. I think it will look better if we also add trim around. Now, some of you might not like all these dark bricks. Not a problem, let's select all of them and see how it would look like with the same bricks like rest of the building. Perhaps let's keep it that way. Now I can see that these stone tiles are way too repetitive, but we can remap some of them on any of these other tiles we have here. Let's go to the rear side and make all these bricks brighter too. What else can we do? Let's select all these side bricks and remap them to the concrete tiles. Now it looks even better. I'll move the banner slightly to the right to sit over concrete tiles. Now we can add a dark bevel line on this side where concrete tiles join with bricks. I just need to select all these planes and remap them to the different texture tile. Let's not forget about this tiny plane down here. Okay, now these concrete tiles also look repetitive. I'll select some of them and remap to the second concrete tile we have here on the texture. Like that. Now, there you go. I hope this was useful. Check the description of this video, I posted a download link to the project file with all the textures. Now you can go and try to create something of your own. So, have a nice day and don't forget to like and subscribe if you want to see more tutorials like this.